أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ياسين والقرآن الحكيم. إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم. تنزيل العزيز الرحيم. لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون. لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون. إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون. وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون. وسواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. إنما تنذر من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب وبشره بمغفرة وأجر كريم. إنا نحن نحيي الموتى ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين. واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إذ جاءها المرسلون. إذ أرسلنا إليهم اثنين فكذبوهما فعززنا بثالث فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون. قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا تكذبون. قالوا ربنا يعلم إنا إليكم لمرسلون وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين. قالوا إنا تطيرنا بكم لئن لم تنتهوا لنرجمنكم وليمسنكم منا عذاب أليم. قالوا طائركم معكم أئن ذكرتم بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين. اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون. وما لي لا أعبد الذي فطرني وإليه ترجعون. أتخذ من دونه آلهة إن يردني الرحمن بضر لا تغن عني شفاعتهم شيئا ولا ينقذون. إني إذا لفي ضلال مبين. إني آمنت بربكم فاسمعون. قيل ادخل الجنة قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون. بما غفر لي ربي وجعلني من المكرمين. وما أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين. إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم خامدون. يا حسرة على العباد ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون. ألم يروا كم أهلكنا قبلهم من القرون أنهم إليهم لا يرجعون. وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون. وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون وآية لهم الليل نسلخ منه النهار فإذا هم مظلمون والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين وإذا قيل لهم اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم لعلكم ترحمون وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين وإذا قيل لهم أنفقوا مما رزقكم الله قال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا ونطعم من لو يشاء الله أطعمه إن أنتم إلا في ضلال مبين ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين ما ينظرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون فلا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون ونفخ في السور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم وامتازوا اليوم أيها المجرمون ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم أن لا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا أفلم تكونوا تعقلون هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ومن نعمره ننكسه في الخلق أفلا يعقلون وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون وظللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون واتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون أولم ير الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم قل يحييها الذي ينشاها أول مرة وهو بكل خلق عليم الذي جعل لكم من الشجر الأخضر نارا فإذا أنتم منه توقدون أوليس الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم بلى وهو الخلاق العليم إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون.
This Surah Yasin was recited for the following Marhum list on the screen. Please recite Surah Fatiha and three times Surah Ikhlas. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een. Ihdina Sirat al Mustaqim. Sirat al Ladina an'amta alayhim. Ghayr al Maghdubi alayhim wa la dhalin. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد سلام
Send your blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, O High, O Mighty, O Forgiver, O Merciful. You are the mighty Lord who has none like Him, and He is the All-Hearing, the All-Seeing. And this is the month which you have made exalted, honored, ennobled, and excelled over the other months. It is the month in which you have made fasting obligatory on me, and it is the month in which you sent down the Quran, a guidance for mankind, having clear signs of guidance and distinction. You have placed in it the night of power, and made it better than a thousand months. O one who favors and none favor you, favor me by saving me from the fire amongst the one you favor, and make me enter heaven by your mercy, O the most merciful. O Allah, send your blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. O Allah, gladden the people of the graves, Oh Allah, enrich every poor person. Oh Allah, satisfy every hungry one. Oh Allah, clothe every unclothed one. Oh Allah, help every debtor pay his debt. Oh Allah, relieve every distressed one. Oh Allah, return every traveler to his home. Oh Allah, release every prisoner. Oh Allah, correct every wrong in the affairs of the Muslims. Oh Allah, cure every sick one. Oh Allah, ease our poverty by your wealth. Oh Allah, change our evil state to a good one through your excellent state. Oh Allah, relieve us of our debt and help us against poverty. Surely you have power over all things. Oh Allah, send your blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. Oh Allah, Lord of Ramadan, the month in which you have sent down the Quran and made fasting obligatory on your servants. Bless Muhammad and the family of Muhammad and enable me to go for pilgrimage to your sacred house in this year and in every year, and forgive me those great sins that I carry. For surely none can forgive them except you, O beneficent, O all-knowing. O Allah, send your blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. O Allah, I begin glorifying you with your praise. You direct towards what is right through your grace. I'm convinced that you are the most merciful in matters of forgiveness and mercy, but most severe in matters of warning and retribution, and the most mighty in matters of power and magnificence. O Allah, you have allowed me to supplicate to you and ask from you. Then hear my praise, O one who hears all, and answer my call, O merciful, and decrease my mistakes, O most forgiving. How often, O my Allah, you have relieved me of my troubles. How much grief you have dispelled, how many mistakes you have prevented, how many blessings you have spread, and how many series of afflictions you have separated. All praise is for Allah, who has not taken a wife nor a son, who has no partner in his kingdom, who has no friend to protect him from humiliation. So magnify him with the great magnificence. Allahu Akbar. All praises for Allah, for all his praiseworthy acts, for all his favors and blessings. All praises for Allah, who has no opposition in his kingdom, nor any challenge to his command. All praises for Allah, who has no partner in creation, nor anyone like him in his greatness. All praises for Allah, his commands and his praise operate over his creation, and his glory is evident through his generosity, whose bestowal stretches out liberally. His treasures never decrease. Rather, the frequency of his giving increases his generosity and kindness. Surely he is the mighty, the bestower. O Allah, I ask you a little from much, although I am in great need of it. While you are eternally needless of it, though it is a lot for me, while it is easy and simple for you. O Allah, indeed your forgiveness of my sins and your overlooking of my faults, your pardoning of my oppression, your hiding of my ugly deeds, and your forbearing my many wrongs, done intentionally or unintentionally, tempted me to ask from you what I did not deserve from you, which you still gave me out of your mercy, and provided me by your power, and made known to me from your answers. So I became habituated to call you trustingly and ask you familiarly, neither fearing nor scared, but with confidence in you for what I intended. Then if there was a delay in your answer, I would blame you due to my ignorance. And perhaps the delay was best for me, for you know the outcome of all affairs. I have not seen a more generous master patient with a wretched slave than you are with me. My Lord, you call me and I turn away from you. You show me affection to me and I show hatred towards you. You display your love for me, and I do not respond as though I am above you. But this does not prevent you from having mercy on me, and being good to me and favoring me through your generosity and nobility. So please continue to have mercy on your ignorant slave. And be kind to him through your excellence of your grace. Surely you are the bountiful, the generous. All praises for Allah, the owner of the kingdom, who makes ships sail, controls the wind, causes the dawn to break, is the authority on the day of judgment, and is the Lord of the world. All praises for Allah, for his patience despite his knowledge. All praises for Allah, for his forgiveness despite his power. All praises for Allah, for the lengthy respite he gives his despite his anger, though he has the power to do as he wills. All praises for Allah, the creator of all creation, the provider of plentiful sustenance, the cleaver of the dawn, and possessor of glory and honor, and the excellence and blessings, who is far and thus cannot be seen, but is close and thus witnesses secret conversation. Blessed and exalted be his name. All praises for Allah, who has no equal, who argues with him, nor anyone similar to him, nor any helper to support him. He overpowers the mighty by his strength, and the great humble themselves before his greatness. He accomplishes what he wishes through his power. All praises for Allah, who answers me when I call him. covers all my faults, yet I disobey him. Increases his bounties on me, but I do not acknowledge them. How many pleasant gifts has he given me? How many great fears he has removed, and how many delightful joys he has shown me. Thus I glorify him, thanking him, and I remember him with praise. All praises for Allah, whose curtains cannot be opened, whose doors cannot be locked, who does not reject the one who asks him, and who does not disappoint the one who places hope in him. All praises for Allah, who provides safety for the frightened, who rescues the virtuous, who raises the oppressed, humiliates the proud, destroys kings, and replaces them with others. All praises for Allah, who crushes the tyrants, annihilates the oppressors, watches over the runaways, punishes the oppressors, assists those who cry for help, who grants the request of the besiegers, and is the confidence of the believers. All praises for Allah, in whose awe the skies and its inhabitants shake, the earth and its inhabitants tremble, the sea and all that swims in its billow. All praises for Allah, who guided us to this, and we would not have been guided had Allah not guided us to this. All praises for Allah, who creates but is not created, gives sustenance but is not given sustenance, feeds but is not fed, causes the living to die, and gives life to the dead. He is ever living and does not die. In his control is all good, and in his power over all, and he has power over all things. O Allah, send your blessings on Muhammad, your servant, your messenger, your trustee, your chosen one, your beloved, the best of your creation, the preserver over your secrets, and the preacher of your messages, the most superior, elegant, handsome, perfect, upright, prosperous, pleasant, holy, and sublime. More than what you have blessed, given, had mercy, sympathize and greeted anyone from your servants, your prophet, your messengers, your chosen ones, and the honorable ones from your creation. O Allah, send your blessings on Ali, the commander of the faithful, and the successor of the messenger of the Lord of the world. Your servant, your friend, the brother of your messenger, your proof over creation, your great sign and the mighty awaited news, and send blessings on the truthful, pure lady, Fatima Zahra, the leader of the women of the world, and send blessings on your two grandsons of mercy, the leaders of the guidance, Al-Hassan and Al-Hussein, the leaders of the youth of paradise, and send blessings on the leaders of Muslims, Ali, son and of Hussein, Muhammad, son of Ali, Ja'far, son of Muhammad, Musa, son of Ja'far, Ali, son of Musa, Muhammad, son of Ali, Ali, son of Muhammad, Hassan, son of Ali, and the successor, the guide, and the rightly guided. Your proofs over your servants, your trustees on your land. Bless them with numerous and continuous blessings. O Allah, send blessings on the guardian of your orders and the one who will rise, the one hoped for, the awaited justice. Surround him with your favorite angels and assist him with the Holy Spirit, O Lord of the world. O Allah, appoint him to invite towards your book to establish your religion. Make him the successor on earth as you cause others to succeed before him. Establish for him his religion which you have approved for him. Give him security after fear so he worships you and does not associate any with you. O Allah, give him power and through him strengthen others. Help him and help others through him. Help him with a mighty help and give him an easy victory and grant him an assisted authority from you. O Allah, make manifest through him your religion and the way of your prophet until nothing from the truth remains hidden from any human being. O Allah, we earnestly desire from you an honored state through which you strengthen Islam and its people and degrade hypocrisy and its followers, and make us in it amongst the inviters towards your obedience and the leaders to your path. Give us through it honor of the world and the hereafter. O Allah, what you have made known to us of the truth, help us bear it, and what we fall short, make us reach it. O Allah, through him put order in our affairs, and through him gather and unite our flocks, and through him join together our separations. And through him increase our minority, and through him lift us from degradation, and through him relieve us our miseries, and through him pull us out of our debt, and through him remove our poverty, and through him fill the gaps in our confusion, and through him ease our difficulties, and through him brighten our faces, and through him free our prisoners, and through him grant our requests, and through him fulfill our promises, and through him answer our calls, and through him grant us all our requests, and through him cause us to obtain what we hope for from this world and the hereafter, and through him give us more than our expectations. Oh, the best of all who have asked, and the most generous of bestowers, through him cleanse our chest, remove the stains of anger and hatred from our hearts, and guide us to the truth on disputed matters by your permission. And surely you guide whom you wish to the right path. Through him help us to ever overcome your enemy and our enemy. O Allah of truth, Ameen. O Allah, we come. complain to you of the absence of our prophet. Your blessings be on him and his family, the concealment of our leader, the abundance of our enemies, the scarcity of our numbers, the severity of our trials, the victory of the era against us. So bless Muhammad and the family and his family, and help us overcome that by granting us an immediate victory. Dispersing miseries, giving us a help that strengthens, providing an authority of truth which you manifest, a mercy from you which is clear to us, and a well-being from you which clothes us. By your mercy, O most merciful, O Allah, send your blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. O Allah, by your mercy, include us with the virtuous, who raise us to be with the distinguished people. Make us drink a cup of water from the spring of Salsabil, and pair us with the Huris by your mercy, and give us the service of young heavenly helpers. Well groomed like pearls, feed us with the fruits of paradise and the flesh of birds, and clothe us with robes of thick brocade of silk and gold. Grant us the benefits of the night of power and pilgrimage to your sacred house, and of dying in your way. Answer our prayers and requests which are good. And when you gather the people of the early and later periods on the day of judgment, have mercy on us. Write for us a protection from the fire, and do not confine us to hell, and try us not with your punishment and your disgrace. Feed us not from the bitter tree, nor the thorny fruit of hell. Do not place us with the devils, nor throw us face downwards in hell, and do not clothe us with the flames and tar of hell. Save us from all evil, for there is no Allah but you. For the sake of there being no Allah but you, save us. O Allah, send your blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. O Allah, I beseech you to a place in which, in what you destine and decree, from the orders in which are definite, and orders which are wise, from the decree which is not reversed nor changed. Write my name as one of the pilgrims of your sacred house, whose Hajj is approved, whose efforts are appreciated, whose sins are forgiven, and whose evil deeds are pardoned. And place for me in what you destine and decree a lengthening of my life in goodness and health, and an increase in my sustenance. Make me among those whom you support your religion, not substituting any in my place. O Allah, send blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. I seek refuge with the majesty of your gracious self from the passing of the month of Ramadan, or the appearance of the dawn of this night. While I still have a duty I have not carried out, or a sin that you may punish me for. O Allah, Allah send blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad. My Allah, the beggars are standing at your door, and the needy have taken refuge with your honor. The ship carrying the poor and humble people is standing at the shores of the sea of your generosity and grace, hoping for permission to cross the shores of your mercy and blessings. My Allah, if you do not forgive in this honored month, accept the one who has sincerely purified himself for you in his fasting and prayers. Then who is there for the negligent sinner when he drowns in the sea of sins? My Allah, if you do not have mercy on any except the obedient, then who is there for the disobedient? And if you do not accept from any except the performance of good actions, then who is there for those who fall short? My Allah, those who have fast have profited, those who have stayed up in prayer have won, and those who are sincere have succeeded. But we are your sinful servants, so be kind to us through your mercy, and save us from the fire through your forgiveness, O gracious one, O most merciful. O Allah, bless Muhammad and his family, the purified ones. O Allah, send blessings on Muhammad and the family of Muhammad.
محمد وعلى محمد صلوات. اللهم صل على محمد. I would like to invite Dr. Vasajani to do a short health presentation. I would like to welcome him with a loud salawat.
Assalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I know that there are lots of brothers outside in the main foyer getting their health checks done. So could I please just invite them in, as many people that are outside, if they could come in. Inshallah, it'll only be 5 minutes before we break for wudu and then salah, inshallah. I promise that this is worth your while. We'll be talking a little bit about diet, particularly during Shahr Ramadan. Okay. Because of the fact that during Shahr Ramadan, you have a very short period of time to eat. So you need to make the most of the fast, and you also need to make the most of the time that you have available to eat. I think we're looking at roughly, we're fasting about 19 and a half hours a day, where we can eat for about 4 hours, and then you've got half an hour of imsak, or 20 minutes. Right, so this is just a short talk, 5 minutes on tips for a healthy month. So we'll be talking about some of the changes that happen in the body during fasting. We also look at a balanced diet. What does a balanced diet mean? We'll also look at some beneficial foods during this month, as well as some harmful foods, the importance of hydration, some power foods as well that you can eat during this month to help stimulate your energy supplies, as well as a little change that you can incorporate in Shahr Ramadan. So this slide, which actually doesn't project very well here, looks at some of the changes that happen during the body. So your body normally breaks down sugars to provide you with energy, and this sugar is called glucose. Okay, so you find that as glucose is broken down, when you're fasting, you're not having that intake of the glucose, you're not having that intake of the sugar. So instead, the body starts to break down fat. Okay, And that means that your blood pressure can improve, your weight can improve, and your cholesterol level gets better. Okay, which and your cholesterol is a measure of the fats within your blood. One of the other things is that endorphins, which are your happy chemicals, are released when you're fasting, and that gives you better mental health, gives you better concentration, and hopefully over the month, and particularly during your fasting period, is meant to put you in a better mood, though I know for some people that does not quite happen. We look at what a balanced diet means, okay? So, interestingly, one of the things that we looked at was a third of your plate has to be carbohydrate. You have to have protein, so meat the size of your palm on your plate, and a third of your plate has to be fresh fruit and veg, and then a little bit of fats and sugars. So we did an experiment where we took a samosa and we broke off the end, we took out all the meat, and we actually found that eating two samosas is equivalent to your entire meal's allowance of carbohydrates and protein. So and the fat component as well, because of the fact that they are fried. So it shows that perhaps indulging in more than two samosas in any one meal is a bad thing, which then makes one think that if you're eating fried foods with every meal, you're perhaps indulging a little bit more than what is good for you. And at the end of the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, eat and drink, but waste not in extravagance, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like those who waste in extravagance. So we usually say that the activity level also has an important implication on the human body, because when you put energy in, you have to spend energy as well. Does that make sense? I'm getting a few blank faces here, so let me know if I'm not making any sense. I want to make it interactive, and I want to try to be of as much benefit to you as I can. So if anything doesn't make any sense, please just stop me, put your hand up, and I can re-explain things, okay? So when you're putting food in, you need to expend that energy. So when you're not fasting and you're eating three meals a day, you need to be doing, studies show, 30 minutes of exercise every day, 5 days a week. And that 30 minutes of exercise is where your heart rate goes up, you become sweaty and you feel out of breath as well. And studies show that doing those 30 minutes, 5 days a week, helps to expend a lot of the energy that you're taking in through your food. Some beneficial foods, so dates, so we say why are dates beneficial during Shahr Ramadan? And one of the main things is that it provides a rapid supply of glucose, which is the main sugar that you use for your energy, as well as a lot of the salts that you don't take in when you're fasting, so things like potassium. Well, when you take a date and then you take a short break to go and pray, that allows 5 to 6 minutes for the dates to start working in the body, to start stimulating your appetite, to start the release of hormones such as insulin, as well as certain hormones within the gastrointestinal tract to help the digestive process kickstart. So that's why I think it's very important to start off with dates, but then to also leave a short break of 5 minutes to go and pray and then come back, because it's better for you. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, everything that is ordained by Islam is of benefit to you. Things that don't help, so fast-burning foods, so white flour, things that are heavy in sugar, such as cakes, biscuits, chocolates, mithai, that sort of thing that we commonly sometimes have because we think, okay, we've been fasting all day, we should perhaps indulge in these things, is not good for you in the long term. And one of the other things is it does fill you up quite a lot, and so you lose out on the spiritual aspect. So the time that you should be concentrating on dua, you find that sometimes your heart is not quite in it because of the fact that you feel quite full. The other thing is that caffeine dehydrates you. So tea, coffee, drinking, you know, Coke, Pepsi, things like that can dehydrate you quite a lot. And particularly because we only have 4 hours within which to take in all our food and water requirements for the entire day and for the entire day ahead, it's very important you use that wisely. So caffeine dehydrates you. So one of the simple things you can do is instead of drinking tea with caffeine, try drinking decaf tea, because you'll still get the same taste. And for a lot of people, it's not about the caffeine, it's about the taste of the tea, which is why we drink it. So try drinking some decaffeinated tea. You need to be drinking at least 2 liters of water a day to try to keep on top of your fluid requirements. And just to put that into perspective, that's about 8 tall tumbler glasses worth. So you can try to gauge in yourself whether you drink that much. Some people do, some people don't. One of the easy ways that I try to keep on top of my fluid requirements is by starting off with some soup, because soup contains, and that I usually have lentil soup, so soup made out of dal. So it has something that's slow releasing, so it provides you with enough nutrients, it's healthy, and it has quite a lot of water inside as well. So main thing is drink plenty of water as much as you can. Because of the fact that water can prevent headaches, it gives you energy, it helps the glucose that you take in be used in a better way to help stimulate the breakdown of glucose. It also helps with the skin, it can help with weight loss as well, and it also helps in the long run with some of your joints as well. So the next thing, I'm trying to go through this very, very quickly. There's a lot to cover, and I know that we're approaching the time of Salah very soon, so I'll go through this very, very quickly. So if you remember in Surah Al-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions some particular fruits, okay? So he mentions within the Quran, he mentions in Surah Al-Rahman, he mentions the pomegranate. And the reason why is the pomegranate is one of the fruits that is said to be from Jannah, but also in this modern day and age, it's found to be a power food. Power foods mean that it releases energy both quickly and slowly. So it gives you that sudden burst of energy, but in the background, it's also running and giving you some long-term energy as well. One of the long-term effects of pomegranates, which has recently been discovered by science, is that particularly for men, it prevents the onset of prostate cancer. It helps treat bowel cancer, and it also helps boost your immune system when you suffer from other cancers as well. But particularly, prostate cancer is the big one that pomegranates help to prevent. So pomegranates are very good. Plenty of fresh fruit and veg, so you'll find lots of greens, so like broccoli, sprouts, spinach, that sort of thing is very, very good for you. Things that we can try to change, particularly with yourselves and your families, are what we've talked about, so the fats, the salts and the sugars. But one of the things that I want to particularly emphasize on is smoking. And because that's a big thing in our community. Often I find as soon as it hits Salah time, as soon as it hits Iftar time, we go outside and we find lots of people smoking outside, which is two things. So firstly, it's harmful for your health. And secondly, it sets a bad impression on the youth, it sets a bad impression on the children, as well as not to mention the risks of passive smoking. So if you can stop smoking, cutting down doesn't help at all. Stopping smoking is the ultimate answer in terms of long-term benefits to your health. So if people who smoke can attend their local GP surgeries and speak to a smoking counselor to help stop smoking, that in the long term will not only benefit you, but will also benefit the community at large. I can't stress the importance of this enough. One of the other things, I was having a chat with a brother outside, and one thing we did discuss was, now I don't know, this might be a little bit controversial, but with the niyaz in the mosque, sometimes we find that the food can be a little bit oily, and sometimes you find deep fried foods, sometimes you find the athano is obviously got quite a lot of oil inside. I wonder as a community, and obviously this is not for me because I'm not on any committees that can request any changes, but would it be worth considering during niyaz time to try to change the niyaz slightly to make it a little bit more healthy, to reduce the amount of oil? So for example, if you're putting in 4 spoonfuls of oil, try putting in 3 spoonfuls and see what effect that has. Because in the long term, that will benefit our community. Outside, when we were doing this health screening just today in a period of about an hour, we found that, to be honest, I found about 90 to 95% of everyone that we screened was in the overweight category, which for our community in the long term is not good because of the risks of heart attacks, strokes, and long-term kidney damage as well. So you can quit smoking. Don't overindulge during Shahr Ramadan. Main thing is plenty of water, and inshallah, hopefully you'll feel the spiritual effects as well as the physical effects as well. If you have any questions, do let me know. I'm more than happy to sit down and answer any questions. If it's not today, you know, I'm here. I'm living in Leicester, and I'm a general practitioner as well. So inshallah, hopefully I can provide some advice. So inshallah, hopefully, let's hope that we can grow together both spiritually and physically over the coming month, inshallah. Thank you for your time. Salla ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Al-Fatiha.